Good afternoon, folks. This is Dan here with the Noah Hyde Input, and today I want to share with you the new launched Non magazine. I was kind of inspired by my friend James and John, who did a little post and gave a little bit of an overview, and so I thought I would do an overview myself and actually give you some deep insights and some pictures and let you review it and tell you more about it. So, folks, here is the cover. I was so excited by putting this together. It took me, I'm going to say, no less than 6 weeks of actual work. And that was after gathering together a lot of stories from people all across North America. I was so overjoyed at the response when I made a post back in early June. And people stepped up and they said, yeah, I would love to be a part of that. And these were respected people, people I know, people I've interacted with on social media or in other Noah Hyde groups. And I just, I said, okay, well, let's run with this. So, I got some nice professional templates and I adjusted them, but I worked on the background pictures and all kinds of stuff and the layout and put it all together and even did a bunch of editing. So you could call me the editor of Non Magazine, which is exactly what it says. Once you get inside the cover, you get to the first page, editor's words, I give a little blurb. My rabbi in Jerusalem, Rabbi Chaim Goldberg, he gives a little excerpt to share along with us because he's thankful that we in North America are starting to bloom and blossom into everything that Hashem has for us as a greater community here in North America. And a lot of people in the world are watching this because, let's face it, people all over the world that are beginning to embrace Torah are really looking for guidance and leadership, and some of them feel disconnected and cut off and all alone. And so, this magazine is intended to tighten up that community. And it is my hopes and the hopes of those that actually contributed that connections begin to build, that people begin to meet people closer to them, that communities begin to form here in North America and abroad. So I know that there are a lot of people over across the globe even looking at this. So it's exciting to be a part of, and the magazine continues and it's loaded with stories, folks. I give an overview of those that are involved. We got Rod Reuven, Rabbi Michael Skobach was so joyfully stepped up and submitted an article for me to use. Rabbi Hirki. Now, Rabbi Hirki is the founder of the Noahide World Center in Jerusalem, and we've got pictures of those involved, and let me just show them to you, folks. That way you can see them straight up, and I'll talk about them a little bit. As we go on, it flips over into the table of contents, and you got to remember that this is a double layout, right? So this is a single page, and then that opens up some really nice-looking, high-end, professional-looking magazine. This is not just something that's been slapped together. It's been really thought about, prayed about, and more than that, put together with love in hopes that you'll share it and share it freely, post it on your webpage, post it on your social media, share it abroad so that people can know that you're not alone in what you do and what you believe, and that that you're not alone in Torah, that people are there for you. Not only is it something that the rabbis are excited to share, but you have validation also. Now, the first article we come to on page 6, Rabbi Hirki, I've honestly never met Rabbi Hirki, but he's a great man. I heard he was just in Brazil doing a tour, if he's still not down there doing a tour in Brazil. These folks at the Noahide World Center are reaching out around the entire globe. They've got rabbis that do work in many different languages in many different regions of the planet. Now, Rabbi Hirki shares a wonderful, wonderful article. You got to read it for yourself, folks. It's called A Unique Myth, Where God Rests His Presence. So there's so much in there, detail that will answer that deep question. And he goes on. Now, I want you to understand that if you go into the magazine, I've got hyperlinks where highlights like on his Noahide World Center star with the rainbow colored star. If you click on that, that's a live link. It's a hyperlink. So it goes to the Noahide World Center's Bridalom page. So that way you can interact and see who they are. I mean, so that's what's great about the digital edition. But I did design it and set the layout for print. So it's there for our hopes is to go to print so that people Just imagine walking into your doctor's office or dentist's office and seeing this on the table and somebody reading it. It might just spark conversation and help build community. But the point of the matter is, hey, I would certainly love to share some of these with others in my community and wherever I am. And so it's just a joy to have rabbis continue to share with us. And I am getting a lot more of them willing to step up and be a part of this. I've got a few more that are willing to be a part of another edition, and they're excited to see what's going on here in North America. Now, one of the points that Rabbi Hirki points out is about agricultural renewal of the Hebrew land is a redemption sign. This is exciting stuff, folks. Check it out. He's got his final words in there, and it's just a blessing to have a gentleman of his stature, the founder of the Noahide World Center, share with us. Now, as we move on to the next page, page number 9, here's a wonderful article by Rabbi Michael Skobach, Seeking Spiritual Connection. And if you look, it's got a live link. Rabbi Skobach he's the Director of Education and Counseling for Jews for Judaism Canada, but Rabbi Skobach is just a wonderful teacher that everybody loves. He's on Tanakh Talk regularly, amongst other things. I have the joy of sitting in some of his live classes. He's just a profound man who shares his heart and shares the Torah as it's been passed down, and he does it with great wisdom and elaborates often. So Seeking Spiritual Connection is just a wonderful article. I'm glad to have it in the magazine, folks. And then as we go on, I've got an article by my rabbi, Rabbi Chaim Goldberg, called Selfie Culture. What does this popular obsession with selfies say about the world today? It's something we all need to know and be aware of and check out. We see it everywhere. People walk around with their cell phones. They're like zombies. And I've seen people bounce into telephone poles and all kinds of stuff. But the point of the matter is they're wonderful tools for doing lots of things. But when it becomes an obsession and it gets out of balance, I'll tell you, it can be a negative, folks. So a great article, Selfie Obsession. What does it say about community today? And I've got live links plus QR codes all over the place, folks, for you to check out. And it goes links to his site, his personal site is BibleVerseOfToday.com. Wonderful classes there, and he does plenty of teaching. I just so appreciate him sharing his lessons with us on Mondays with a group in Vilnius, Lithuania, and a lot of people in Europe. He's always going into depth, the Hebrew words with us, and we've been 22 weeks still in Genesis, and we're only on chapter 4, and I just enjoy everything he shares. Now, the next couple pages got a 2-page spread on the big picture. The Sheva Mitzvot, or the B'nai Noach, or otherwise known as the Noahide Code. Now, this article, folks, I had 7 folks that I have known on social media and met some of them, and I asked each one of them to do one of the 7 mitzvot and talk about it in about 100-150 words or so. And I tried to find people that would fit, could come up with something in their life. And it's just amazing how our life experiences actually begin to come to fruition when we're able to help others in a certain area. And I find that these folks that have shared here in this section know what they're talking about. They know exactly what they're talking about. And so as we move on, the 7 Noahide laws, they work in real life. I show where these folks are from in North America. So there's a globe or the continent itself with the pins in there where these people are from. And first we have Not to Worship Idols by James Lurick from Pennsylvania. James call himself a radical Torah supremacist. He's a person who's actually gone so far as to learn to fluently Hebrew. And so he was the right person to share about Not to Worship Idols. And below, down in Vermont, we have Jessica, Not to Curse God or Blaspheme. Jessica is a wonderful lady, a mother in Vermont, who you'll find her on social media quite often being a top fan with Tovia Singer. She just likes to get involved and share the Torah and learn from the Torah. And she shares a wonderful little article there. As we go on, I've got my friend Jennifer down in North Carolina, establishing the courts of justice. And Jennifer really wanted people to notice in the end, in those days, there was no king in Israel, and every man did that which was right in their own eyes. So you really need to look at that little blurb, folks, because Jennifer tells it like it is, that the call to establish courts of justice and be a part of that is something that we all need to be cognizant of and support our politicians. I know it's difficult to do with lots of parties and people with crazy ideas, but we need to rally for courts and for laws that actually support the Sheva Mitzvot, that support the seven laws in the Noahide Code, so that people can the morality can flourish, and Hashem will have his way here on planet Earth. Now, as we move on, my friend Richard down in California, Richard Helton down in California, he shares on not to commit murder, and I find Richard a wonderful gentleman. He shares some classes on Thursday nights if anybody's interested. Look him up on social media. He's always got a lot to share, and he studies, and he digs, and gets all the sources. And below that, we've got my friend Angela from the Lower Mainland, Langley, BC. She's right near Vancouver, Canada, folks. No sexual immorality. What a wonderful person. She just celebrated her 30th wedding anniversary, so shout out to you, Angela. Her real name is Angelica, but her handle online is Angela. Angela, appreciate everything you do, and thank you so much. And as we go on in the seven Noahide laws, not to steal or no theft is everybody's good friend, Veronica Port from Washington, Tacoma, Washington. Veronica is just a sweetheart of a lady. She helps out with many Noahide groups and many Noahide pages, and does a newsletter for Rabbi Shlomo and a bunch of other involvement. One God, Seven Laws, and she's involved in so much more. She actually did a broadcast with me to tell her story of her trip to Noahide on our PNN page, that Pacific Northwest Noahide, if anybody's interested. But she's just a wonderful lady to share on how not to steal, no theft. And so I just thankful, Veronica, for all that you do. Now, the seventh one was so difficult, and I actually had a couple people pull out, but I was able to find a friend down in Arizona, Patrick Peace down in Arizona. And, you know, Hashem knows what he's doing, because this gentleman is the perfect person to deal with the seventh, not to eat the flesh of a living animal. Now, that sounds like something that just nobody does today, okay? And it sounds odd, and it sounds strange, but it does go on, and people don't realize that it does. Now, Patrick is a beekeeper. He's a farmer down in Arizona, and often, if you read his article, often they have to go higher and higher and higher into the mountain area so that the bees can get access to the pollen and the flowers in the cooler, because it gets so hot down in Arizona. But Patrick's story is unique in that he is friends with many other cattle farmers in the area, and they have a lot of barbecues, and they have a lot of get-togethers, and he's invited quite often for what they call I lived in the prairies in Canada. They called them prairie oysters there. I'm not going to tell you. You got to read it for yourself, folks. But I'm telling you, know that he was the perfect person for this job, for this a specific mitzvot, sharing not to eat the flesh of a living animal. As we move on, folks, on to page 19, when confronted by negativity, I find that this gentleman is Terry Hayes, just a wonderful gentleman from Chattanooga, Tennessee. One of the soundest Noahides that I know down there in the United States. He does some broadcasts with Pesach Sherbo out of Sfat, Israel. More than that, he's got a couple of blog pages, and I've got a link here to his newest blog page, backtogenesis.com. But more than that, he shares with us as Noahides how to deal with negativity if we're confronted, especially a lot of us that came out of Christianity. We have a lot of family and friends and loved ones that are just can't understand why we made the cerebral decision that we've made to embrace the Noahide laws, and yet Terry gives a wonderful article here about how to deal with it. You check him out on social media anytime. He's always got something great to say. Now, as we go on to page 20, folks, I've got a very nice spread here, a few pages spread here by a wonderful gentleman, a former Baptist minister, who actually took a trip to the Holy Land to visit his children who converted to Judaism. But more than that, he is quite a scholar in his own rights. This is from Larry Beck, and he sent me some wonderful pictures and wrote a wonderful article while he was over in the land of Israel, talked about Mount Carmel today. He made that trip down there, got some beautiful photos for us, folks. So there's plenty of that there. He talks about Haifa and how it's pretty much, it's somewhat difficult if, you know, in Israel, the land is growing so fast. It's quite a metropolis in many, many, many places. It's hard to get your mind into, you know, the days of the Tanakh when, the prophets roamed the land and the kings of Israel ruled. It's tough to get an idea, but it is there for those that want to search archaeologically and check a bunch of sites out. But I'm so glad to have Larry Beck share this article, and he just shows some wonderful, wonderful pictures. More than that, he gets a beautiful overview of the Jezreel Valley today, also known as the Valley of Megiddo. Check that out, folks. Thank you so much, Larry. Everything Larry shares, I love his jokes, but more than that, when it comes to a hard question or something that's difficult being a Noahide, Larry's always there with a good sound word. Now, as we go on to page 26, 27, we get into the middle of the book. So if somebody's opening this as a magazine, this would be our center spread. And who better than to have William Hall from Tanakh Talk? I mean, I love this guy. I love the show he does. It's been so inspirational to me. And more than that, it's inspirational to thousands. And, you know, I did an interview with William Hall and wrote this story, but it's based on his words as William tells it. And I asked for the story behind how did Tanakh Talk start. You got to read this article. But more than that, folks, this show, Tanakh Talk, is something we all need to get behind and financially support. We need to step up and financially support it, because this show is a staple, and more than just a staple. It's been going on for 5 years. William's narrowing in on his 700th episode, and I know that the rabbis just enjoy working with him, and his show's only getting better and better and better. But the story, you know, people know that William's still working full-time and pouring out his life's blood, heart, and soul to make this happen for you, for the cause of Torah. But read the story, how it all began, true humble beginnings, and how it started out in the early days and a small early set that had to be set up regularly. Folks, read the article. And more than that, as you go on and read the stories of those we know and love that he brings in daily, people tune in weekly, you know, to catch their favorite rabbi. But more than that, William has brought us so many others that we haven't saw in a while. But more than that, he could use our support. So I've got live links everywhere on this page, so you can click on, go right to the Tanakh Talk donate page. Folks, I encourage you, support that show. If anything, support that show. And I'd love to see more and more episodes as we continue, as time goes on, and till the Mashiach arrives. So, but as we go on, we have, I got several pages from Rod Bryant, down at Nativ. Now, Rod he's the director of education and counseling at Nativ, and Nativ is Center's worldwide path for Torah learning. They have got groups all over North America. And more than that, his place down in Texas is a hotbed where rabbis will go and record a lot of broadcasts, and he does a lot of meetings. But more than that, Rod is a former pastor who's actually just, you know, embraced the Jewish calling and embraced the Sheva Mitzvot. And more than that, he's a great teacher. And so he shares with us the essential Rebbe Nachman and a bunch of information on that. And there's some wonderful pictures of what's going on down in the Nativ Center down in Texas. And as second article he puts in, I'm just being true to self. You've got to read. This is a wonderful read. It's a beautiful looking magazine, folks. Check it out. I'm going to post the link at the bottom of this for anybody so that you can click on it, go right to the live link digitally and see it, review it, check it over. And you know what? Get on social media. Reply to me. Let me know what you think. Let me know how I can improve. Let me know what should be done. I am getting calls to do the second edition already. So I hope Rod's going to continue to be a part of it because, you know, he's got so much to share and he's a wise man. And we're just honored to have him a part of this magazine. And it's just a joy going forward. I couldn't see doing it without him. But as we go on to page 34, I got a nice 2-page spread by a wonderful person that steadily labors each and every week to connect people together. This is Nancy Todd Overall from Louisville, Kentucky. And Nancy has just been dear to me. And she's the chief administrator for the Noahide Online Gathering. And all I can say is she's just a beautiful soul, and I hope she's doing well. And more than that, the article is just one that tells it like it really is today. The state of Noahide in North America in general, touch your heart, really real stuff to give you a feel of what's going on and how loose-knit communities are and how we can be tighter and there's room to grow. But more than that, she gives guidance and she's steadily there for people. And I hope she's doing well. As we go on, folks, on page 36, I got the dynamic duo of you, Tom. And if you haven't seen these guys on social media or anywhere else doing broadcasts, YouTube and whatever, the point of the matter is you, Tom, stands for Universal Truth of Mankind. And this is David Benshall and Michael Clark. Now, these two guys have done far more than 300 episodes, okay? But I find they're not afraid to tackle deep subjects, get involved, mix it up, learn and understand, and they're not afraid to adjust their lives and change if need be, as they see in the Torah. David's a scholar, and Michael's jumped on board to help him out with his tech stuff. More than that, Michael knows his stuff as well. They guys share a wonderful article. They're out of New Jersey. Actually, Mike's just in North Georgia, so they make it all happen there on the northeastern seaboard. I appreciate these guys, getting to know them more. I even did a broadcast with them, and I find them quite inspiring, and they're not afraid to reach out to anybody, and they're just happy guys trying to share the truth of Torah and get the beauty of the Torah out there so that people can see exactly what it's all about, and their article is wonderful, and there's a link on that big symbol plus at the front page. It goes to their site as well. Now, as we go on to page 38, this is me in here, meeting a genuine war hero. Now, I'm in the Okanagan, British Columbia, Canada, which is the interior. I'm about 3.5 hours in from the Pacific Ocean and a beautiful lake and a beautiful region. If you read this article that I put together, we have a local Chabad in Kelowna, British Columbia, which is not too far from me, that put on a presentation that they just crammed the room with probably, I'm going to say, 1,200 people. I don't think they could get any more, with a wonderful, honest war hero, 99-year-old Martha Cohn. This lady has been decorated with so many medals, but more than that, she got up and shared her story and her book. I got to do a VIP meet and greet with her backstage for about almost an hour. She's just a tiny lady at 99. She barely comes up to my waist. But more than that, she's got more life and more energy than 20-year-olds that are out there today. She's just the real deal, true war hero. And you got to read her story. Get her book out there. That's called Behind Enemy Lines. She was 19 years old when World War II broke out, and only just turned 25 when it ended. And, what a story. She shortened the war, and she was born in northern France, right near the German border. And to hear the story, and she's a Jewish lady Jewish family, but born in France. I mean, they had to move to the south. Her sister passed away in Auschwitz. But more than that, I mean, in her prime, she was just somebody who was there, ground level involved. But more than that, she had a heart for life. She had a heart for seeing people saved, and had enough of the death that she just played a tiny part. But people thought she was useless. You got to read the story, folks. People treated her as just a teeny petite little lady who can't do anything in a war. But don't kid yourself. If Hashem's called you to do a purpose, if he's with you, you just never know. This tiny lady shortened World War II, and she's the real deal. We even had in this top right corner here, we even had the Canadian Minister of Defense, the Minister of National Defense of Canada, showed up, flew in for this event, okay, and presented her with another medallion, a World War II medallion on behalf of the Canada, on behalf of the country of Canada, and it just went in with the stockpile. But then to hear her share her story live, and then even beforehand to get a VIP session alone with her was just such an honor. And this lady's going to keep touring until Hashem takes her home, and she's 99, seems to be going strong, and just a joy, and I hope you enjoy the article. Please check it out. Now, as we go on page 40, I was still looking for a little more Canadian content, and this gentleman was recommended to me by Rabbi Michael Skoback. His name is Lee Patton. He's from Brantford, Ontario, which is not too far from my original hometown, and he gave me a nice article on Gematria Thoughts, and he shares on the phrase Baruch Hashem, and he takes us on a nice Gematria journey to just throw tidbits of mind teasers that really, really help you understand the history behind the depth of the phrase. You know, it's a typical blessing. Blessed is the Lord. Jews and Noahites say so. Check that article out. You'll enjoy it, I'm sure. Now, as we go on, there's my friend Terry Hayes again with his other blog site, Immunitrek. And I've always enjoyed reading Terry's articles. He's just a kind Noahide scholar, but more than that, it's what he writes. It's what he shares. It's proven. Now, you know, Terry went through for 6 years. He was going to go through a full Jewish conversion and then just started to stay Noahide and focused at it. And here's a gentleman who's got just wisdom, but he'll never tell you that. but we just see it, and we're thankful for everything he shares. So, you know, check out this article where he tells his story, and enjoy. Enjoy. It's great stuff. And then as we move on, we get a little family and fun section. See how it's done. And I was honored to have a couple of people that were referred to me share who they are and what they do as Noahides to help make the world a better place and affect their community in a positive way. And the first person, Mr. Mustache. Now, this was phenomenal. He shares us his story, the rabbi and Mr. Mustache. It's an inspiration to be who you ought to be. And the rabbi in the picture is Rav Dror, say no more. The Rav Dror and this gentleman, Jesse Hammack, met Rav Dror when he was doing a national tour last year, opened up his home to him and his family. And the rabbi and Mr. Mustache was born. And Rav Dror blessed him just with inspiration to be who he ought to be and change his life to do what he feels he should be doing, what he's called to do. And get this, folks, this guy has a PBS show coming up soon, and he's got a book coming out. And what he does is he reaches out to Alzheimer's patients, to the elderly in hospitals, and he does painting classes, and he puts on a comedy show for them. And he touches and impacts their lives. And he's just free spirited and going after it. And this is what being alive is all about. And he was truly inspired by Rav Dror. So you've got to read this gentleman's story. You're going to see more of this fellow as time progresses, because I tell you, he's just the real deal, sharing who he wants to be and impacting lives in a positive way. And as you go on and read his story, there's not much more to say. He's out there touching lives in his community. He's from Santa Rosa Beach in the Florida Panhandle, hot down there, beautiful country, ocean views. But more than that, he's helping a lot of elderly in his community and helping them have a better quality of life as he brings joy into their lives. And he's going into hospitals and in elderly homes and helping those that are sick and in need and actually having a great impact. And I'm sure we're going to see much more of Jesse as time goes on. Now, as we keep going, folks, we're coming down to the end, page 48. We also have in the Family of Fun section a beautiful article on raising Noah. And this is written by my friend Shara Shabaki from Florida as well. Now, Shara has children. She knows what it's like. And can good be better than great? Sounds on. Check it out. She knows exactly what she's talking about. Talks about a parent trap and how to deal with children and actually make it work. And She's just a wonderful person that actually gives great advice. And I know you can't go wrong, folks. I hope you enjoyed what you've saw so far in the magazine. And as you flip down to the end is the tail end of the back cover. And I threw on there the code. It's just the right thing to do. No idol worship. You think about what you're doing. No blasphemy of the Almighty. You know, really think about what you're saying. And no murder. I mean, every life, man's every human life is precious. It shouldn't be wasted. And no theft or robbery. Honestly, work for what is yours while respecting others' property. And no illicit sexual behavior. You know, control yourself and have honorable connection with others. You know, and don't have any cruelty for animals. I mean, this is really ever. I mean, be thankful for your food, folks, and be at harmony with the environment. I mean, specifically, do not eat the limb of a living animal, as such is torturous and cruel of heart. And also establish courts of justice. Labor for the systems that support and enforce the other six parts of the code in order to make the world a better place for future generations. Now, folks, I want to encourage you, if you enjoyed this magazine, you know, if you enjoyed this magazine, you know, we want to go to print. So please feel free. I've got some of these out there on social media, Facebook and whatnot, but you can go to my website. That's godovertime.com. It's www.godovertime.com. Look for the $1 donation tab. Click on there. You know, we need to raise about $3,200 to make this work, really. I mean, and I'm not doing this for the money. I mean, I'm doing it to make sure that prints. Our target is to print 2,000 copies. And if we can print 2,000 copies and get them out there in the right places, you'll see them all over the place. We just believe it might help grow Noahide communities all over, but more than that, change people's lives and have them connect with a wonderful rabbi that might just draw them closer to Hashem. And Hashem's doing a wonderful work. So feel free if you see this donation tab somewhere. I could really use it to make it work. You know, I'm only 50 blah, blah, blah years old. So, you know, I'm a little too young to retire, but I mean, I do this out of the love of my heart. And I really hope that, Hashem opens opportunity to continue doing this magazine. Like I said, I've already got several articles for the second edition, and I want to do that, but it really comes down to support. And I've set the print deadline determination to September 20th. I mean, that's only 15 days away. And so at that point, I got to say if it's viable or not, because there's a lot of licensing and things involved to make it all work. And if I'm going to make that commitment, I'd love to make this a quarterly edition. It's a beautiful, beautiful magazine, and I'd love to have your support, folks. So, you know, if you enjoy what you saw so far, check the link out below. It's in digital. I'm monitoring all the stats. We're getting loads of people check it out, mainly on cell phones, over 50% of them on cell phones. I did not design the layout specifically for cell phones, but you can zoom in. You can read it. It's beautifully crisp. No loss of resolution at zoom in at 400, 800%. It looks great on a computer screen, on a PC or laptop, even a tablet, folks. Check it out. Feel free to write to me or send me a social media tab. You know, the next couple of weeks are critical. I need the support to make sure that this happens, that we go to print. They're asking for some copies. I'd love to send it no less than 100, a couple hundred to Jerusalem in print form so that people can see what's going on here in North America. And the big news is that we're also in talks with other people, with people at Noahide World Center. They'd love to see it go in other languages. We've got people asking for other languages, and we have had a couple people step up, said that they could possibly translate to Russian. I know there's a great Russian community growing out there at Noahides. Some person had mentioned Portuguese. Be nice if we could get Spanish as well. And there was also some French folks that said, we'd love to see this in French. We need to see this in French. If we have the support, I don't mind spending the time if sending the articles as as text to the right people and doing the layout in a different language. I don't mind doing this. It's got to be supported. But more than that, just supported, it's got to be shared and it's got to impact. But check it out. It's a beautiful magazine, and I hope it touches your lives. And, you know, let me know if you like this Noahide input. Maybe I'll be doing some more shows in the upcoming future. So till then, Dan signing out.